We wanted to partner with Mugs to promote their new Raspberry Spring Splash Latte. We promoted the drink by using the AIDA selling model. We wanted to get the customer's attention by having the customer see the sign when they walked in to raise awareness of the new product. The next thing we wanted to do is get their interest by having them guess the ingredients, and if they were able to guess correctly, they would get a free 16-ounce spring special. We wanted to use both types of guerrilla marketing, non-interactive and interactive. Since we mainly see non-interactive, we used the poster board that contained all the information a customer would need to know to enter the contest, such as take a drink, take a picture, and send your photo using the hashtag #WhatsInYourMug. We also wanted to use interactive, because by interacting with a customer one-on-one and seeing if they were willing to try a sample and enter the contest, by using interactive, it does have smaller reach, but it does have a higher effective rate. We also used unconventional methods by using social media and having customers post the photos and their guesses using the hashtag and post it to their Twitter or Instagram accounts. By having the customers upload their guests and photos, it helped to create user-generated content and help spread the word of Mug's new product by using word of mouth. I am still in love with that place. When the stars are the only things we share, we'd be there.
One technique we used in presenting our interactive activity was the framing, otherwise known as prospect theory, which in short is the concept that losses loom greater than gains. Because we were asking people to give up their time to participate, we wanted to make sure that the time they gave was perceived to be worth it. So we would present the opportunity to win a free drink first, the game, and then explain the commitment needed, the loss. With the product we were promoting, Mugs used Just Meaningful Difference in the creation of that product. It was much like other lattes with the presence of milk and espresso, but with a slight variance of raspberry in the flavor. It was enough for the consumer to notice, but not to think it was a completely different product. Consumers used assimilation product congruity in their tasting to come up with an appropriate name for the drink. From the reaction we received from the consumers, we can assume that they used the exemplar method, which is the identifying of a product by comparing it to pre-existing products, because they could recognize that it was coffee by what they've tasted of coffee previously.
In the campaign, we choose to focus on the customer marks because we think that opinion leaders, they are coffee drinkers and they are really sensitive with the new coffee products. Their opinion toward the new coffee will have great impact on the behavior of other customers. Therefore, it's advantageous for us to use them to spread the words. Furthermore, we think that the core personality trait of Mark's is competence and sincerity. We want not only to introduce them about the new products, but also make them understand the personality of Mugs. It's also the reason why we choose to organize a taste test campaign, an interactive and competitive marketing strategy.
As our concept revolved around consumers tasting a new product and subsequently trying to formulate a suitable name based on the ingredients they tasted, the use of sensory memory was implemented by everyone who tasted the samples. Consumers would initially assess the look and texture of the sample, using their iconic memory to determine that the product looked similar to a coffee substance. The consumers would then smell the sample, implementing their olfactory memory to determine the type of variation of coffee. Finally, the consumers would then taste the coffee sample using their protein memory to identify the ingredients that may be present. Once they had completed this sensory memory process, the consumers would then use the information that they had processed to come up with what they thought would be a suitable name for the product.
Since we were working with mugs, we wanted to use our signs to match the company colors. By using red, gray, and black to match the company logo, we hoped this would give the familiarity of mugs that people know so well. The signs we used were also placed at eye level to make sure to catch the eye of people walking by. By matching mugs as much as we could, we hoped to promote trustworthiness that the brand Mugs carries as we promoted a new special. Throughout our marketing process, we did come across a couple of obstacles. First, the weather was not on our side, causing us to be placed indoors of mugs, which in turn limited the consumers in contact with the product to being those that were only coming into the coffee shop already. Our second limit was if participants did not have or engage in social media platforms. However, despite these minor limitations in our marketing process, we still were able to create awareness for the Raspberry Spring Splash Latte at Mugs.